So Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year a hundredfold. I decree a hundredfold upon your life, only if you have a job. I decree a hundredfold upon your life, only if you are doing business. I decree a hundredfold in your life, only if you get something that you engage in doing. That is what God is going to increase. Increase your health, increase your finances, increase your business, increase your dream, increase in every area, but you must be doing something. Turn to your neighbor, say, get busy. One more time. Hallelujah. He sowed and he received the same year, the same year, the same year, the Bible says, a hundredfold, and the Lord blessed him. I decree hundredfold in all that you will do. I decree hundredfold in your going out. I decree hundredfold in your coming in. I decree in the midst of battle, there will still be hundredfold. I decree in the midst of famine, there will still be hundredfold. I decree in the midst of trials, there will still be hundredfold. Now pay attention. The man did not eat what he had. In the midst of the famine, he sowed what he had. How dare you try to sow in the midst of famine? Are you crazy? There is no rain and you are planting. You see the revelation there? Pay attention. It means that the man did not depend on the natural system to make it in life. He was not even looking for rain. Rain or no rain, God had promised and I will sow. Famine or no famine, God had promised and I will what? I will sow. So when we base our life, when we base our decision, when we base everything that we do according to the promises of God, forget about nature, forget about system, forget about the economy. We fixed our eyes and our minds and our will on the will and the ways and the word of God. It's going to work. It's going to work. The Bible says that God gave instruction to God, to his people, that they should dig well and that they should not look for rain. He said, dig trenches. And God says, I will fill it without rain. The people were thinking that maybe if we dig these trenches, what's going to happen? God is going to cause rain to come. God says, no, I'm not causing no rain. He said, you dig it. Dig all the trenches that you want to dig. Dig them as much as you can and go home. The guys, they were digging. They dug as much as they could. They went home the next morning. It was filled. No rain. God was saying, I am in charge. I am Jehovah God. Nature cannot rule me. I am in charge of nature. I am in charge of system. I am in charge of government. Listen, if you are looking and believing God for a certain thing and government say no, go to God, the higher government. And when God say yes, not even your prime minister will say no. When God say yes, that lawyer will not say no. When God say yes, that immigration officer will not say no. When God say yes, your manager will not say no. When God say yes, the doctors will not say no. When God say yes, trust me, even if you are the most unqualified candidate, you are still going to make it in Jesus' name. I believe God and I doubt the storm. I believe God and I doubt the storm. I believe God and I doubt. Do you know that after this man sold, it is not natural. Within the same year, you are reaping much more than what you've sown. And you are reaping 100, not just 54, 100, 100-fold that same year. The Bible says, plus that the Lord blessed him at the end of verse 12. Verse 13, and the man waxed great. Today you will wax great in Jesus' name. Wax great. That waxing great anointing should rest upon you. That hundredfold anointing should rest upon you. You see, that is why I hate when Christians say, Pastor, I just feel like giving up. I want to die now. Oh, Lord, you know, the problem is too much for me. I cannot handle it. No, it is the problem that ought to be complaining that this man, this woman is too much for me. So I turned to the left, she punched me. I turned to the right, she punched me. I go forward, she punched me. I go backward, they said, hey, you see this one, don't bother yourself. You cannot win over him or her. Why? Because the Bible says, greater is he that is in you than him that is in the world. You will wax great in Jesus' name. in this land of Canada, in the city of Toronto, I decree you shall work great in Jesus' name. You shall go forward in Jesus' name. And you will go until you become very great. Hey. Now look at the word. The Bible says, the man, he works great. He go forward until he becomes very, very, very great. Now, do you also discover something in this scripture, this particular verse? The Bible says the man grew. How something grows? Something grows from down upward. That is vertical, right? And then how do you go forward? This way, forward, right? That's horizontal. Vertical lines, horizontal lines. Vertical lines, horizontal lines. What does those two lines symbolize? It symbolizes the cross. Thank you, Pastor. Those two lines, vertical lines and horizontal lines, they symbolize the cross. So as long as you live and believe and abide your life within the cross of Jesus Christ, you will make it in Jesus' name. You will make it. You will make it. Let them say whatever they want to say. You are going to make it in Jesus' name. You'll be very great. You'll be very great. It's just a matter of time. Verse 14. And he had possession. Now you see, the man that wanted to run away, he had possession of flocks, possession of herds, and great store. Can you imagine? Store of servants. I've never heard that before. Imagine that. He had great store of servants. And the Philistine envied the man. They were jealous. What are you doing? You're a foreigner. In fact, this is our place. This is our country. You ought not to be here. They feel intimidated. Hallelujah. And then the Bible says, they envied him. Verse 15. And all the wells which his father's servant had digged in the days of Abraham, his father, the Philistines had stopped them. Now pay attention. And filled them with earth. And Abimelech said unto Isaac, go from us, for thou art much mightier than we. What makes the difference? It's the presence of God upon this man's life that makes the difference. Not his status, not his credential, not his background, not his race or his tribe or his family name. If God, that's why people used to say, if God is for you, nobody will be against you. Even if the whole world is against you, as long as God is for you and with you, you will make it in Jesus' name. So stop condemning yourself. Amen. Now, something that I discover, let me point something that I discover. If you watch, the Bible says in verse 15 that after Abraham died, the Philistines, they went and they stopped. They blocked all the well that Abraham, his father, had dug. Now, pay attention. If you looked at your Bible very well, you also see something, some very important things that happen. Abraham went and dug so much wells in his days in this same land. And afterwards, the Bible says, they close up everything against him. In Genesis chapter 20, if you see chapter 20, verse 25 to 34, you will read that. And in chapter 26, verse 18, you will also read that. Abraham struggled with Abimelech. They had some contention to the extent that the father Abraham gave up. But now Isaac is saying, I am not going to give up. Whatever, pay attention now, whatever you have stopped my father from doing, I will do. I announce to you today, those things that your fathers never achieved, you will achieve in Jesus' name. Those things that stop your parents will not stop you. Hallelujah. Any power that deny you or your generation or your forefathers, they shall not deny you in the name of Jesus. It's a time of change. It's a time of new beginning. The Bible says Isaac now overcame the famine, and he also is also about to overcome the Philistines by going back to his father's well and dig up again. Now, there's so much we're going to learn, but we discover, let me just summarize, we discover that he dug the first one, he dug the second one, they covered it, he got the third one. I mean, they took them, first and second one, they took them away from him. God kept blessing the man. God kept blessing the man. And finally, the third one, they could not fight against the man. They could not contend with him, and they gave up. And the man says, God has given me rest. That's where I'm going to be dealing with some issues by next week. But I want to give you a few more scriptures
Let's say two more, and then we're going to pray.
Amen?
Because God has never failed. He has never and he will never fail. If you go to verse 28, it says, and they said, verse 16, they said, go away from us, because you're too mightier than us. Verse 28, they said, we saw certainly that the Lord was with thee. And we said, let there be an oath betwixt us and betwixt us and thee, and let us make a covenant with thee. These people came. They came to Isaac and they said, let us make an agreement. Let us make a covenant. There's so much I'm going to say next week about the covenant and about the promises that God has promised. And I'm going to give you some few secrets as to what we ought to do in order to maintain these promises that God has promised us and for us to see the fulfillment. Because many times we blame God, but God has said it. If you don't act upon it, it's never going to work. Amen? You have to act upon it. You have to believe God. Believe God because God will take you through your entire life without you failing. Go with me to the book of Psalm 48, verse 14. Psalm 48, verse 14. Psalm 48, verse 14, and we're going to continue next week by the special grace of God. Psalm 48. Hallelujah. You are not alone. You are not alone. Psalm 48. We're going to read that together. Are we ready for this? Verse 14. Are we ready? What does this say? For this God. Which God? Idol? Nope. Fake God? Money? Money is not my God. Pleasure? Fame? People? No. For this God. God of Abraham. God of Isaac. God of Jacob. God who is faithful, never lie, never change. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Alpha and the Omega is Elohim, El Shaddai, El Elyon. He's Jehovah. We call him Abba Father. This God is our God forever and ever. Forever and ever. He says he will be our guide even unto death. How many Christians will say that? For this God is my God forever and ever and ever. And he goes by saying, he will be our guide unto death. It means that this are men and people who have made up their mind. They are settled on the promises and the integrity of God and saying, we're not changing for no one else. We're not backing out. No problem will push me away. No trials. No challenges from the enemy. No attack. Because this God is our God forever and ever. This God is our God. How? Forever and ever, and we will continue to serve and trust him until death. Until death. Have you ever meditated on scriptures like that? Say, wow, this God is my God forever and ever. The doctor gave me a report, but I believe in this God because he's my God forever and ever. And the landlord ejected me. I believe in this God that is my God forever and ever. Oh, I failed the exam the other day and the professor said I will not graduate. But this God is my God forever and ever. Oh, my finance has failed. Check my account. My credit is so terrible. I want to buy a house and the banks rejected me. But this God is my God forever and ever. Oh, I'm believing God for a miracle. For a new car, a new home, a family. I want to get married. I want to travel. I want to start a career. I want to start a new business. Because why? This God is my God and is your God and is our God, what? Forever and ever and ever. Stand to your feet and say that to the devil. This God is my God forever and ever and ever. Isaac could say that to Abimelech. Isaac could say that to the Philistines. So when this God said to him, don't go, so he says, this God is my God forever and ever, even unto death. I will sow because he will not lie, he will not fail. Lift up your hands, lift up your voices, and begin to speak unto the Lord right now. And tell the Lord how much you are sorry. Because many times you've acted in fear. Many times you've acted in unbelief. You've been acting in doubt. Instead of faith, you are afraid.
We're sorry, oh God, for acting in doubt.
Lift up your voices and begin to pray right now.
We're sorry, oh God, for acting in fear, Heavenly Father.
Our God is an unchangeable God.
God, you're powerful God.
The Bible says he will never fear.
Nor forsake us, oh God.
He will never fear.
Give us.
He will never fail you. He will never fail you. God can be trusted. He can be trusted. He can
be trusted. You're trustworthy.
He can be trusted. He can be trusted. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. God will not fail you. He will not fail you. He will not fail you. He will not fail you.
To doubt, oh God.
Even Job in his life, when everybody go away from him,
fail us, oh God Almighty.
His wife says, curse him and die. He says, no.
You remain faithful.
No.
You will remain faithful.
Not my God. I will stay with him. Let the whole world go away from you. And let the whole world be against you. But let God stay with you.
You remain faithful to us, oh God.
Let the Lord be your God. David said, create in me a clean heart, O God.
You can be trusted.
Renew the right spirit within me.
We trust you, God.
Cast me not away from your presence.
We trust you,
I need your presence. I need your presence. I need your presence, sir. I need your presence, O God. The hymn writer says, I need thee every hour. Most gracious Lord. Most tender voice like thine.
We're gonna focus on
peace of all. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior.
Kayakala Bush.
Ete riba brata yalaba.
That's gonna be our focus, Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Anything else, Heavenly Father, is a distraction.
We're not gonna base our faith based on what we see. We believe your word. We believe your word. No matter what the world is saying, no matter what the doctors are saying, no matter what we fear, our eyes are on you.
We serve a mighty God.
Our eyes are on you, Lord.
We serve a mighty God.
Lord,
we serve Almighty God. We serve
Almighty I am not
God.
Going to run away from this battle.
We serve
I'm not
going
to give up
God.
In this battle.
We serve
I am bound
God.
To win.
We serve
I am bound to win. Say, Lord, I am bound to win.
Lord, we are bound to
I will
end.
Fight to the very end.
We'll fight to the very end.
I will fight
end,
to
oh
the
God.
Very end. Yes,
we'll
Lord.
Fight,
yes,
oh
Lord.
God. We'll fight to refuse to back down, Heavenly Father. We're not going to surrender,
yes,
oh God.
Raise up your hand. I'll pray with you shortly. Lord, we come before you as sons and daughters this moment.
Yes.
We repent of every sin in our lives.
Yes.
There's nothing that hurts you the most like unbelief.
Yes, Lord.
When we could not believe you as God, but we believe the problems. When we could not believe you as God, but we believe sickness, we believe doctors, we believe the police, we believe the immigration, we believe the lawyers, we believe teachers, we believe people. We don't believe you. God, have mercy upon us for such unbelief. Enable us to see you as who you are and take you at your word.
Yes.
Israel wandered through the wilderness for 40 good years because of unbelief. Lord, we don't want to be wanderers in this life.
No way,
we don't want to waste the opportunities that we have in this life.
No way, Lord.
With all the promises and all that you are doing, We are not going to live the same way, oh God.
Refuse, oh God.
We pray for a change in our lives.
Yes.
We pray for increase of faith.
Yes.
We pray for strong courage.
Yes.
We pray, Lord, God Almighty, for that faith that will move mountain.
Yes.
So that we will say what you have said.
Yes.
We will believe all that you have believed.
Yes.
And that which you have promised, that which you have said about us.
Yes.
It will begin to work in our lives in Jesus' name.
So shall it be. Yes.
Father, when you have said yes, who is that devil that will say no?
No.
Who is that human being? Wait. This devil and human being, you are the one that created them.
Yes, Lord.
Instead of us fearing you, we are fearing people. Your heart says the heart of the king is in the hand of the Lord. Your word says when you stretch your hand, no man will push it back.
Yes.
Your word says you decree a thing and shall be established.
Yes.
Our eyes are on you, O God.
Yes.
Do for us what you've done for Abraham.
Yes.
Do for us what you've done for Isaac.
Yes.
Do for us what you've done for Jacob.
Yes.
And that the covenant promises of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will be our portion in Jesus' name.
So shall it be for us.
Change our mindset, oh God.
Yes.
Change our heart condition, oh God.
Yes.
Change our perception, oh God.
Yes.
That we will begin to look at you and you alone. In the name of Jesus.
So shall it be. Yes.
Every spirit of lying.
Yes.
Every spirit of fear. Every yoke of sin.
Yes.
Every wrong imagination.
Yes.
Every evil thought.
Yes.
Every
Lord.
Demonic concept of failure. That which you have not said.
Yes.
That which you have not planned. That which you have not promised.
Yes.
That we want to believe. That is not of your will. We move away from our lives in the name
yes,
of Jesus.
So shall it be. Bakarabosa. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Lord, we believe your word.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Lord, we believe in your integrity.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we believe that you will not fail.
Yes, Lord.
Hey, we're not going to leave this life without a legacy.
Yes, Lord.
We're not going to leave this life without a testimony.
Yes, Lord.
We are not going to fail.
No way, Lord.
Not when you are God in this life.
Yes.
Lord, we are not going to fail.
No way.
Not when you are on the throne in heaven.
Yes.
We are not going to fail.
No way.
Not when all powers in heaven and earth has been given unto you.
Yes, Lord. We receive it. Bakarabosa. Yes, Lord.
Father, we rather die than we fail.
Yes, Lord.
We rather born than we fail.
Yes, Lord.
Because you are not a failure.
No way.
You have said in your word.
Yes, yes.
That we shall prosper.
So shall it be
we
for us.
We shall walk in righteousness.
So shall it be for
we
us.
We shall live a holy life.
So shall it be
we
for us.
We shall be victorious over sin.
So shall it be
we
for
shall
us.
Be victorious over the world.
So shall it
we
be
we shall
for
be
us.
Victorious over your problems.
So shall it be
I
for
decree
us.
The goodness of God in your life in Jesus' name.
So shall it be for us.
If you are sick, I decree. I'm not binding and losing. Because I have no business with him.
Yes.
I am concerned with what God has said.
Yes.
He said by his stripes you are healed.
So shall it
whatever
be.
Whatever sickness, whatever disease this morning.
Yes, Lord.
You are healed in Jesus' name.
So shall it be.
Because God has said it.
Yes, Lord. You have
by
said it.
By his stripes you are healed.
So shall it be.
I am here.
Yes.
I believe you are the head and not the tail.
So shall it be
I
for us.
I am the head and not the tail.
Yes, that's who we
I
are.
I believe you will prosper.
Yes, that's who
I
we are.
I will prosper.
Yes, we are.
I believe you are a child of God.
Yes, we are.
I am a child of God.
Yes, Lord, we are.
I believe you are victorious.
So shall it be for us. Amen.
I am victorious.
Yes, Lord.
I believe you are not going to be rejected in Canada.
No way.
I believe you will become a citizen in this land.
So shall it be for us.
Because the earth is your father's property.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
So shall it be.
Every man that is believing God for this immigration in this land of Canada, I decree you are a citizen in Jesus' name.
So shall it be.
By reason of the anointing in this house today.
Yes, Lord.
By reason of the promises of God in this house today.
Yes, Lord.
By reason of the integrity of God and the faithfulness of God.
Yes, Lord.
You are going to be a citizen in this land.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You are healed in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
You will be victorious over your sin in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
You are blessed in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Because God will make you
Yes,
God,
Lord.
God will perform for you.
Yes,
and
Lord.
And God will bless you.
Yes,
and
Lord.
And God will do you good.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for our families.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for our loved ones.
Yes, Lord.
We just give you praise.
We believe you have been blessed. You are welcome to join us at any of our fellowships on Wednesday at 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. for Bible study, Fridays at 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. for prayer session, and on Sundays at 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. You can reach us at 647-707-3738 or at 647-345-8708, or send us an email at faithhealingca@yahoo.com or faithhealingca@gmail.com. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and connect with us on social media. Thank you, and God bless.